Hello friends, once again I am there, and as I told you in the last video that today I am going to tell you how to compile and run the program of Java in NetBean, and how to work with NetBean, and how to compile and run program on the command prompt. And today I will be telling you that what is the difference if you are compiling and running a program by NetBean and you are compiling and running a program by command prompt using Java and Java C command. So, just first of all, I have to write a simple program in Java, and then I will be telling you how to compile it, how to run it. I will not be telling all the components of this program today. In next lecture, we will be discussing that what is the meaning of public static void main and all these. First of all, just you have to understand what is the program structure and what is the program structure and how to run a program and compile a program. So just see, and I am coming here, coming back. And I will be telling you how to write a simple Java program. So first of all, in any Java program, we have to create a class, because this is a pure object oriented language. And in which way we have to write? So first of all, you have to import the libraries, or you can say import the packages. How to do that? For that purpose, I have to write import java.lang.star. First of all, I have to write this line. After that, you have to create a class. So just class test, and now inside that you will be seeing I will be writing main method. Main method will be telling to my compiler that from which place the execution of the program, compilation of the program will be started. So I will be writing public static void main string arg, you can write args, okay. And now after that, what I have to do, I am writing, just as we are writing in C, that printf function. Now I will be writing println function there. So system dot out dot println, okay. At this place I am writing b n e n g I n double e r b n engineer, just I am writing this. So this is the way of writing of any Java program. So your program compilation and running will be started by public static void main. This is necessary to write. If you want to just compile your program, then this is okay. This is okay. If you are just you have to compile your program, this is okay. That no any need of public static void main. If you want to run this program, then your program will not be running without public static void main. Either you have to call methods of that somewhere, only then it will be working. So here I am writing system.out.println. Now friends, I am going to work with NetBean, and inside that you will be seeing that I will be writing the same program in NetBean, and then I will be compiling and running that. So how to work here, how to work with the NetBean, you can see how to work with that. Just a minute. Okay, so how to work with that? What you have to do, you have to click here, you have to start new project. If you are not having any knowledge of this NetBean, just I am going to tell you two or three things. This is file, edit, view, as things are available in every IDE, and NetBean is an IDE integrated development environment. Why I am saying this is integrated development environment? Because you can access your database here, you can work with web pages, you can access your web server there. Means this NetBean is not only for the purpose of programming, this is for the purpose of what? This is for the purpose of complete development. So this is complete development environment. Why we are learning programming? We are learning programming for the purpose of developing something, creating something. If lifetime will not be doing only and only programming. Fine, after the learning of programming, you have to learn so many other things, like only JSP will not be working. You have to learn, HTML, you have to learn JSP, and then you have to learn database so that you can make the database connectivity. You have to learn how to work with web server. So many things you have to learn. So why we are saying this NetBean is integrated development environment? After learning so many things, you can work with all the technologies through a single window. That is why we are saying this is integrated development environment. So how to work with that? Just I have to click on new projects, and now you can see the features of integrated development environment. Not only with Java, you can work with HTML5, you can work with Java Enterprise Edition, you can work with Java car technologies like programming of credit cards, etc. You can work with PHP, you can work with Android. So many features are available there. So first of all, because we have to work with core Java, so I am clicking on Java, and then I am clicking here, I am selecting here Java application, and just click on next. And you will be seeing this is Java application 30. You have to memorize, you have to remember that, so that we can find our application in the project list. Just a minute. So what was the name of our application? That was Java application 30. So just find out where is Java application 30. That will be somewhere. Okay, we'll trying to find out it later. Naturally, that will be here. Java application 30, but as you can see, as I was writing here, you can see it here, that now this class and public static void main will be coming automatically in NetBean. So you have to focus only on this line, means only on logic you have to focus. So just memorize for a second class test, and then you are writing public static void main. After that, you have to write system.out.println. Now I am going back, and you will be seeing this is public class Java application 30. It is just like my class. It is just similar to my class. You can see it here. It is available there. Just you can see it is test. Now after that, I am going back. Now public static void main is there. So this is public static void main, and public static void main is there. So public static void main is string args. This is available there. Public static void main is there. But you will be seeing this is only the format. So format will come automatically in NetBean, and we have to focus only on coding. So just I am going to write system.out.println there. System.out.println there. Okay, so I am writing system.out.println. Okay, I am writing system.out.println, and I am writing here b. I am writing here b n n g I n double e r b n engineer. This NetBean is very, very helpful, and you will be seeing that so many things are coming automatically, like this double quotes, etc. Now, how to compile and run this program? This is my run, and just directly you can run this, or first you can compile. So now there is a need. Where is my 30 Java application 30 project? So here my Java application 30. This is my project, and this complete is project structure. So Java application 30 is there, and then Java source package. Inside that, when you are going, you will be getting your exact program. This is my exact program, Java application 30. This is my project. Inside that, there is one folder, that is source package. Inside that, there is another folder, that is Java application 30. Now you have to click here, right click, and you will be getting the option of compile and run both. So just if you want to compile, then just click here. It will be taking some time, and you will get the result of compilation. If there is any error, I will be creating one error intentionally, and then you will be seeing what error will be displayed to you. Just wait one second. First, I have to see the result. So you are seeing there is BN engineer in output, means I have run my program successfully. Now I am going back and I am creating an error there. Just I am deleting this one, and now I am going to run my program and I have to see what is the problem there. So because already class file is prepared, so I have to go back and try to compile and run it. Naturally in admin it is telling the error here, and if you are doing debugging of this file, then naturally you will be getting the error inside that. Already class file is prepared, that is why we are not getting error, and compile option is not coming here. So when you are compiling, then naturally you will be getting error, and I can copy the same program to another place so that you can see the error, because as I told you, refactor it. Okay, now my program is this one. I am going to run it. Just a second. Okay, I am going to create a new project. Now finish it. Now I will be writing, I am copying it from BN Engineer, Control C, and just paste it here, Control V, and just see, try to compile it. Now compile is enabled. Now I am compiling it and you will be getting one error. There is one error of semicolon, means syntax error is there. After that you can correct it. Now I am going to correct that. I am going to put one semicolon here. Now come here and just run it or compile it first. Now it will be compiled successfully because no error is there. Now I can run it and you will be seeing BN Engineer. So this is the way. Now friends, I am going to compile and run the same program with the help of one copy, Control C, Control C, and now I will be putting that in Notepad. Just see the Notepad here. I will be putting it here. I will be changing the name of that. For example, this is test, T-E-S-T, test. Okay, so this is my test program, and I have to remove the error. Now I will be putting semicolon there because I know. Now I will be saving it in Java bin. But friends, I am telling you, this is not the standard way that you have to save each and every file inside the. Just find out where is program. P program file is there. In program files you have to find out Java. So Java is there. There are many versions installed on my PC, so I am storing that in JDK 1.7 inside bin, and then give the name to this. For example, test, T-E-S-T dot java. Okay, now in all files you have to save it test dot java, but you have to be careful at what place you save your file. So just I am minimizing it. Now this time I will be compiling and running from command prompt. So just open the command prompt. In run cmd you have to write. After writing, now cd backslash, And now cd program files pro. Now you can press tab so that program files will appear there. Now after that cd java ja, so tab java will be there. Now cd jdk jdk, now tab jdk 7 point this, but I have to confirm in which I stored, so that is why just I have to confirm first that I will be going here, and then you have to see where is program files. In program files java just click on java, so you are getting java there. I put my source code file inside this. Now here you will be seeing bin and find out where is your test program. So just press t, my test.java is available there. So I have to move to this folder jdk 1.7.0. so I am going here jdk 1.7.0, so I am correct here and I am clicking now cd bin. Okay, so bin. Now I have to check java c is working. So there are two commands, one is java c and java. So now come back to the window and see in which way we have to compile and run the C programs, this Java program. Now if my Java program is test.java, test.java, so how to compile it? On command prompt you will be writing java c and test.java, test.java. Okay, now how to run it? At the time of running we have to use class file name. Okay, so my class file will be prepared by test, so I will be writing java and test only, test, java and test only. So this will be the way of compiling and this will be the way of running. Okay, one more thing you have to remember about the compiling and running: run by source code file name, and compile and run by class file, class file name without extension. Okay, without extension we have to use. So if I am saying a class file, class abc, and file name is spqr dot java, so can you tell me how to compile and run? Then you can see here java c pqr dot java, and run by java c, java c, run by java. So I will be writing this class file name abc. So this is the way of compiling and running on the command prompt. Now I am going back to the command prompt. Now I will be running my file there. So what I have to do particularly, just a second, Just a second. So now friends, what I have to do basically, now I am going to compile and run the same program, okay, and you will be really enjoying it. Now how to compile and run, you can see it here easily that how to compile and run. Now as I told you, just once more you have to go back and you have to see that how to compile and run the program. Just you can brush up that. As I told you, if Java C, Java, if program name is pqr.java, then we will be compiling Java C space pqr.java. If we have to run it, then Java and class file name you have to put. Once more I am telling, because it was not displayed, Java C and pqr.java and Java ABC. ABC is the class name and pqr.java is the file name. Now come back to the main window, and now at this place I will be writing javac java c test test dot java. Okay, so it will be taking some time and then you will be seeing the output. Java C invalid, because Java C is not working there. Java C invalid flag test dot java. Okay, so I have to find out Java C is working, JVAC, Java C is working there or not. Okay, Java C is working there, it is good that there is some error. Now I have to go back and I have to see it here, and I have to find out my program is available there or not. So in Java it may be available. I put it inside the bin and my test.java is there. Okay, test.java java is available there. So I am going back Java javac Java C and test.java. Okay, my program compiled successfully. Okay, now by which name I have to run it? Just after compilation, friends, you have to see at the same place inside the bin the test dot class will be appear. Test dot class file will come there after compilation. If you don't believe, then just I am deleting it. Delete it. Okay, come back to the main screen, and once more when you will be compiling, now both are on screen. As I will be as this program will be compiled immediately, test dot class will be available there. Okay, so just I'm compiling now, this test class appeared there. Okay, now how to run it? By class file name. So I will be writing java and test test test. Okay, now see the output, be an engineer. So this is the way. As I told you, you can compile and run program you can compile and run the program by Java C, Java, and by NetBeans. Now friends, there is a big question there that if NetBeans is available there, then what is the need of Java and Java C? Particularly Java C and Java are available in JDK. Both commands are available there. You can see just come back and see it here. Just come back and see it here that Java C and Java, both commands are available there. Okay, at this place Java C is available there and Java command will be there. Java command, both commands are available inside the JDK. So when we are working with NetBean and I am pressing the compile button and just you can see it here, then when I am coming here and then I am running, then behind it Java is working. When I am coming here compile, then Java C is working behind that. So NetBean is using JDK at the back end for the compilation and running of Java programs. So friends, this was the difference of compiling and running Java program by NetBean or by command prompt, but we have to work with both, because today, tomorrow, if you are going to create any software like NetBean, then you have to use Java C and Java, and you have to do the implementation of that through front end GUI. So friends, like this channel, subscribe this channel and click on the bell icon so that whenever I will be publishing a new video, then information you will be getting by your you can say Gmail, and you will be well informed and you can enjoy my video. So thank you very much.